Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. I am Neha Paryani and in this session we are going to discuss the topic called oversubscription, okay, regarding issue of shares, right? So this is the third video on this chapter called accounting for share capital. There are already two videos on the channel regarding it, okay? If you're watching the third video directly, I would recommend you to please watch first two videos or else you will not be able to understand the third one. Okay, so there is a process. I'm trying to follow a certain process. So watch videos according to that process. If you want the link of the previous videos, you can get it in the description box below, or I will also provide you the videos at the end of this video. Okay, so keep watching. Now, oversubscription. So basically in first video, we have discussed about the concept, whole process of issue of shares, right? In second video, we have discussed the common journal entries, which we need to do regarding this issue of shares. Now, there is a concept called oversubscription. Okay, that's nothing but oversubscription of shares. Now, what does this mean? Okay, like suppose I have given you example. So there is a company, assume this is a company A Limited, okay, and this wants to issue shares to general public. Okay, now company is willing to issue 1000 shares, assume of rupees 10 each, right? So basically company wants to collect 10,000 rupees from public. Okay, company is in requirement of money. So company wants to collect 10,000 rupees from public. This is a very small figure. I'm just taking it for example. Okay, so now company is willing to issue how many? 1000 shares. So company gives the public notice or it gives the advertisement regarding its issue. Now suppose A Limited is a very famous company, or you can say yes, A Limited is a company which is doing good in the market. So now generally what will happen then? So people will be willing to purchase the shares of A Limited. Okay, there will be more demand for the shares of A Limited. Okay, even though company is wishing to issue only 1000 shares, public will subscribe for more than 1000 shares. Like suppose 1500 members of 1500 people are interested in purchasing the shares of A Limited. Okay, but company has only 1000 shares to issue. This situation, this scenario, we call it as oversubscription. Okay, so people are interested in purchasing more shares than the company is willing to issue. This is called as oversubscription. So here 500 shares are extra. Okay, 500 shares are extra which company should do not want to issue. Okay, and remember, overcapitalization is also not good for the company, right? So company may reject these shares. If company accept these extra shares, then company has to pay extra dividend to its shareholders, and also there will be situation of overcapitalization in the company, which is again not a good case. Okay, so now when oversubscription happens, generally companies have two options. Okay, so in case of oversubscription, company has two options, we can say. Okay, one option is to reject. Okay, one option is to reject the excess shares. Okay, if the excess shares are rejected, like suppose 1000 shares to be issued, but we got application for 1500 shares. So these 500 excess shares can directly be rejected by the company. Okay, and by process we know that before allotment, people will pay the application money directly into company's bank account, right? So while applying for shares, people will directly pay certain amount. Okay, in case the company is rejecting this 500 shares, then immediately company has to give back or refund the amount of these extra share applications. Clear? In case the company is rejecting these extra shares, excess 500 shares, then obviously people must have paid application money for these shares also, right? So this money has to be immediately refunded back to general public by the company. Okay, first option is rejection of excess shares. In that case, refund is very important, or refund is compulsory here. Now what is the second option then? Okay, sometimes what happens, sometimes company do not want to reject anybody's shares. Okay, if the company reject the shares, it demotivates the general public. Okay, suppose next time if company again wants to issue the shares, then people might not be interested, because first time their shares got rejected. Okay, when they wanted to apply for the shares of this company, at that time the shares were rejected. Then in second time when company wants again certain capital, people will not be interested in purchasing the capital, purchasing the shares. That will usually demotivate them. Okay, so in order to avoid that situation, what company does, company will also accept these extra 500 shares or excess 500 shares, but the allotment of shares will be made on pro rata basis. Now what is this? Allotment on pro rata basis means what? So second option is, second option for the company is accept all and allotment on pro rata basis. This is the second option. Now what does this mean? Okay, so let me explain you the second option now. So assume, okay, one second. Yes, so people applied for 1500 shares. Okay, and company wanted to issue 1000 shares. Okay, so let me take example of a single person. Assume A. Mr. A has applied for, suppose 10 shares. Okay, A has applied for 10 shares of A Limited. Okay, so yes. Now, company has to accept all 1500 shares. Okay, it has to allot shares to every shareholder. It do not want to demotivate any of the shareholder, or it do not want to reject any of the shares. Okay, now what happens, company can say to Mr. A that you have applied for 10 shares, but instead of 10 shares you will be getting only 7 shares. Okay, so this is what we call it as allotment on pro rata basis. Basically here companies allotting shares to everyone who has applied for the shares, but not in but the allotment of shares is not made in the for full shares that were applied for. Like Mr. A has applied for 10 shares. Mr. A wanted to purchase 10 shares of A Limited, but he is being allotted only 7 shares. Okay, so in this manner what happens, so all the people who has applied for shares, they will be getting, but in lesser quantities. This is what we call it as pro rata basis, or allotment on pro rata basis. Okay, I hope it's clear with the concept now, right? So we are going to do three problems on oversubscription. Okay, in first problem we will be seeing the case when the shares are rejected, right? In the second problem we'll see the case when the shares are, all the shares are accepted and the allotment is made on pro rata basis, and in the third question we'll see both cases together in the question. Okay, so yes, there is another point here. Now suppose company wanted to issue 1000 shares. So during application, company has asked for 4 rupees out of 10. So 10 rupees was the share price, right? Each share value was 10 rupees as per our example, right? So company asked to pay 4 rupees during application. So if 1000 shares were subscribed, company was expecting to get 4000 rupees during application process. Clear? But now in this case 1500 shares have been applied, so 1500 all the applicants are paying 4 rupees. Okay, so now company is getting how much? Actually, company is getting 6000 rupees during application. So 1500 multiplied with 4. Everybody is paying 4 rupees on each share. Okay, for 1500 shares, company is getting 6000 rupees during application process. But company expected how much? That it will be getting 4000 rupees. Now this 2000 rupees is extra here. Okay, this 2000 rupees company has received extra amount from its applicants. Okay, so now in this case, assume company is not rejecting anybody's shares, company is accepting all the shares, then what about this 2000? See, if company rejects this 500 shares, extra shares, then this extra 2000 rupees has to be immediately refunded. Okay, if shares are rejected, the excess amount will be refunded. If the shares are not rejected, if the shares are allotted on pro rata basis, then this 2000 rupees will be adjusted in further process. Okay, we know the process. First process is application. We know that. After that, shares will be allotted to the public. Allotment is the second process. Then afterwards we have calls. So first call, second call. Okay, first call is the third process. Second call is the fourth process, like that. Okay, so during application, company is receiving 2000 rupees extra, excess. Okay, this will be adjusted with the next process, that is allotment. Now, what does that mean? Adjusting the excess money with allotment means that, suppose now during allotment, company is asking to pay 3 rupees. Okay, out of 10 rupees, 4 rupees have been asked to pay during application. Now 3 rupees company is asking to pay during allotment. Okay, so for 1000 shares, company should receive rupees 3000. Okay, but in this case, what happens? Already company has received 2000 rupees extra during application process. So now this will be adjusted during allotment process. Clear? So public has to pay less amount during allotment if excess amount is paid during application. Okay, suppose people had to pay, shareholders had to pay 3000 rupees. Now they only have to pay 1000 because already out of 3000 rupees, 2000 has been paid in advance during application. So during allotment, public or shareholders will only pay 1000 rupees. This is called adjusting excess amount with allotment. Okay, this excess amount can be adjusted actually with any step. It could be adjusted with any step. It will be mentioned in the question. In case it is not mentioned in the question, then we assume that it's adjusted with the second process, that is allotment itself. Here, this is called adjusting with allotment. If company is rejecting the shares, immediately this will be refunded, no doubt in it. If company accepts all shares and make the allotment on pro rata basis, then this 2000 excess amount will be adjusted with next process. Okay, I hope the concept is clear up to here. Okay, so now let us try to do problems on it. So as I told you, we will be doing 3 problems. Okay, one on each case, right? So let's have a look at the first problem. Alpha Limited issued 10,000 shares of rupees 10 each. Okay, so company is issuing 10,000 shares and each share price value is 10 rupees. Each share price is 10 rupees. Application money was, out of 10 rupees, 4 rupees was received on application. Allotment money was 2 rupees. Okay, and first and final call money was rupees 4. Okay, so if you total all this, 4 plus 4 is 8 plus 2 is 10. If you total all this, it must be equal to its share value. Okay, share value per share. Okay, so yes. Now, out of 10 rupees, company is asking 4 rupees during application, 2 rupees during allotment, and 4 rupees during first and final call. Okay, now public applied for 12,000 shares. C company wanted to issue 10,000 shares. Public is subscribing or applying for 12,000 shares. So this is the case of oversubscription, right? So, and company rejected 2,000 shares. So here 2,000 shares were extra. Okay, so all these shares are being rejected by the company now. Pass necessary journal entries. Okay, so we have to pass the necessary journal entries here for every process. Okay, we know that for each step or each process, we have two journal entries. Okay, what are the entries we have discussed already in the previous video? Okay, so I told you entries will be same, only the amount will be changing in every question. Right. So first, let's do the first entry for application process. Okay, so basically here what happens? So first entry for application process will be C. Company is issuing the shares. So in application process, what happens? First, general public will pay the amount to the company's bank account. Okay, so first of all, we are receiving certain amount into our bank account for application of shares. So bank account will be debited. Bank balance or bank is my asset. So my bank balance is increasing because people are paying the application money to the bank account. So when asset increases, we debit it. Bank account is debited to share application account. Okay, we are receiving money for share application. How many, now how much amount, it's very important here. See, people has applied for 12,000 shares. How much company wanted to issue? 10,000, but it doesn't matter here. Actually, how much amount we have received? Okay, that is what matters here. We have received rupees 4 for 12,000 shares. Application money is 4, right? So for 12,000 shares, we have received 4 rupees into our bank account. So 12,000 into 4 will be 48,000 rupees we have received for share application. Okay, same amount will be credited, 48,000, right? You can write the narration being share application money, being share application money for 12,000 shares at rupees 4 per share received. Okay, at rupees 4 per share received. Writing narration is very important, and you also have to include number of shares and application money or allotment money in that narration. Okay, it's very important. Right, then next, the second entry in the application process itself is company will now transfer the application money to the share capital money. To the share capital account. Okay, we have received the application money. This will be transferred to share application. Share application money actually will be transferred to share capital account. Okay, so what will be the entry? Second entry here. So second entry here is share application account debit. Now this share application amount is transferred to share capital amount. Share capital account, sorry. Share capital account. Actually, this is the second entry for the application process. But this is a case of oversubscription. So we have to do a certain change, or we have to do an addition of certain entry here. Okay. Actually, this is the second entry. So what happens? Total 48,000 rupees is application money, right? We company has received 48,000 rupees for application. Okay. Now, so company is rejecting certain shares. Company is rejecting 2,000 shares. So what I told you, if company is rejecting the shares, immediately the excess amount, okay, excess amount for this 2,000 shares has to be refunded. has to be refunded by the company. Okay, so then we need to do certain change in the second entry of application. Okay, so because amount is being refunded, it means now my bank account should be credited, right? Why? Because when we received application money, my bank balance increased, so I debited it. Okay, now if I am refunding the money from my bank account, my bank balance is reducing, right? So I am going to credit it. Now, how much should be how much amount should be transferred to share capital account and what amount should be refunded is very important here. Now see here, company wanted to issue 10,000 shares and it expected that it would be getting 4 rupees during application for 10,000 shares. Okay, company wanted how much? 40,000 rupees during share application process. Clear? Now, so yes, company wanted 40,000, that amount is transferred to share capital account. Now, how many shares were excess? 2,000 shares, which were all rejected by the company. Okay, so we have to refund money for 2,000 shares for at rupees 4. Application money is 4 rupees, right? So for 2,000 shares, we are refunding 4 rupees per share. In total, company is refunding 8,000 rupees. Okay, if you total debit and credit, it will be same. Out of share application money, which is 48,000, 40,000 rupees has been transferred to share capital account, which was required by the company, and remaining excess share amount has been refunded to the general public, right? So you need to write the narration being share application money or share application amount for 10,000 shares at rupees 4 per share transferred to share capital account and 2,000 shares were rejected by the company. Okay, this is how you need to write the narration, right? I hope both the entries for application process is clear with you all, right? Next. So next entry, next process is allotment process. We again have to do 2 entries for allotment. Okay, now here what happens, company is allotting or distributing the shares to its applicants. Okay, so 2,000 shares have been rejected. Remaining for 10,000 members or 10,000 people who has applied for shares, company is distributing or allotting the shares to them now. And during allotment, company is asking to pay 2 rupees out of 10. Out of 10, 4 rupees has been already paid during application. Now company is asking to pay 2 rupees during allotment. Okay, now what will be the 2 entries during allotment process? So in allotment process, what happens? First, company will ask the public to pay the amount. Then we have to do the entry for asking, or you can say due entry. Then after company ask the ask for payment, after that public will pay the amount to company's bank account. Okay, public will pay the allotment amount to company's bank account. So during allotment process, general public become shareholders because shares are being allotted to them now. Clear? So company general public becomes shareholder now. Now shareholders will pay the amount to company's bank account. First company is asking. So we need to do first entry for asking process, and second entry we will do for the when shareholders will pay the amount. Okay, so first entry here in case of allotment will be share allotment account debit, share allotment account debit to share capital account. Okay, so company is asking for 10,000 shares, company is asking to pay 2 rupees during allotment. So 20,000 rupees company is expecting to receive during allotment. This is entry for asking or due entry. Still the allotment amount has not been received by the company. Write the narration being share allotment amount for 10,000 shares at rupees 2 per share due. Okay, still this amount is due. This is the first entry for allotment process. Now second entry during allotment process will be, now the shareholders are paying the amount into company's bank account. Okay, they are paying 2 rupees per share for allotment process into company's bank account. Now again we are receiving certain amount in the bank account, so bank account will be debited because bank balance is increasing. Bank account debit to share, now share allotment account. We are receiving amount for the purpose of share allotment. Okay, for 10,000 shares company received 2 rupees. In total company received 20,000 rupees during allotment. See, company asked to pay 20,000 rupees in total, and company is receiving 20,000 rupees in total during allotment. So write the narration, being share allotment amount for 10,000 shares at the rate rupees 2 per share received. Okay, now the company has received the amount, so it's received now. Clear? These are the two entries during allotment process. Now third process, or third and last process in this question, is first and final call money, or first and final call process. So during this process, company is asking remaining 4 rupees out of 10 rupees. Okay, 4 were paid during application, remaining were 6. 2 rupees were paid during allotment, so remaining were 4. Remaining 4, total full 4 rupees company is receiving during first call. Again, what happens here, first company will ask the shareholders to pay the first and final call money. Okay, so we'll do the entry for asking. Then after asking, the shareholders will pay the first and final call money to company's bank account. This entry will be very similar to share allotment. Okay, it will be very similar to share allotment entries. So first company is asking to pay the first and final call amount. So share first and final call account debit company is asking for 10,000 shares to pay rupees 4 rupees per share. So 40,000 rupees is due for first and final call to share capital account. Okay, 40,000 rupees same. Right narration, being share first and final call amount for 10,000 shares at the rate rupees 4 per share due. Okay, still this amount is due. Shareholders have to pay this amount. Now, what will be the next entry when company asked to pay them the money? Shareholders are paying the first and final call money. Okay, so again my bank account will be debited because my bank balance is increasing. We received 10,000 shares, we received 4 rupees per share. So company received 40,000 rupees during first call. Okay, here to share first and final call account credit. This account will be credited. Okay, see here, the entries will be same for every question, but only the amount, this bracket amount, okay, number of shares and the amount will change. Okay, that is what you need to take care of. So write the narration here, being share first and final call amount for 10,000 shares at the rate rupees 4 per share received. Okay, so this is how you do the journal entries for full of this question. So in this case, in this question, there was a case of oversubscription. So all the extra shares were directly rejected by the company. Amount has been refunded. So only the changes were made in the share application entry. Remaining allotment entries and first and final call entries were basic only. Okay, these are basic entries. This will be same in every question. Only the changes were made in the share application entry. Clear? So this was the case when shares were rejected. Now let's have a look at second question. So in this question, let's see what is the case. V Limited issued 10,000 shares of rupees 10 each. Again, issued 10,000 shares of rupees 10 each. Payable rupees 4 on application, rupees 3 on allotment, and balance on first and final call. So what will be the balance here? Out of 10 rupees, 4 rupees is being asked during application, 3 during allotment. So remaining is how much? For 7 rupees are already being asked, remaining are 3 rupees. So this will be asked during first and final call. Okay. Public applied for 12,000 shares. Okay, but company allotted shares on pro rata basis. So it's not given that these extra 2,000 shares are being rejected. It means company is not rejecting any shares. Okay, but company is allotting the shares on pro rata basis. It means shares are being allotted to everybody, but in lesser quantities. If somebody asked for 100 shares, okay, they will be given 60 or 65 shares. Right, so that is what we call it as allotment on pro rata basis, but shares will be allotted to each and every applicant. Nobody's shares applications will be rejected. Now, and adjusted the excess amount with allotment. Again, this is also very important point. So companies getting certain excess amount, right, that will be adjusted with allotment. So I'll tell you how to do entry about this. I have already explained you the concept. I'll tell you the entry. Then record these transactions in the journal of a company. Okay, fine. So basically, issued 10,000 shares but got subscription for 12,000 shares. So 2,000 shares are extra here. Okay, so we need to do journal entries. Three processes are there. Again, application, allotment, and first and final call. Okay, so first let's do the entry for application process. So we know the entry. First, we will receive the application money into our bank account. So company's bank account will be debited. We received application money for how many shares? 12,000 shares at rupees 4 each. So again, 48,000 rupees is debited to share application amount. Note, share application account, 48,000 rupees. Okay, so again, you need to write the narration, which is being share application money or share application amount for 12,000 shares at the rate rupees 4 per share received. Okay, see, during application process only, first we will receive the amount. During all other processes, first company will ask the amount, then we will receive. Okay, that is why in all other process, second entries, bank account will be debited in the second entry, not in the first entry. Right? Yes. So first entry is done. We received 4 rupees. Okay, for every share, for 12,000 shares. Now, the amount has to be transferred to share capital account. Okay, share application amount has to be transferred to share capital account. So let's see what we'll do with the excess amount here. So entry, second entry will be share application account debit to share capital account. Actually, this is the entry, but again, this is the case of oversubscription. So there is certain excess amount during application. See here, company issued 10,000 shares at rupees 4. The company was expecting 40,000 rupees during application. Correct? Then 2,000 shares are extra here. Okay, company received applications for 12,000 shares at rupees 4. So people paid 48,000 rupees into company's bank account. So this 8,000 rupees is extra, right? This is excess amount. Okay, they are telling this excess amount during application was adjusted with allotment and adjusted the excess amount with allotment. So it's adjusted with the second process. So now what to do about this? So in share capital account, see here, application money is 48,000. In share capital account, how much we will transfer? We'll transfer only for 10,000 shares which company wanted. So 40,000 rupees will be transferred to share capital account. They are telling excess amount is adjusted with share allotment. So we will credit share allotment account now. Share allotment account will be credited. Rupees 8,000. Excess amount is 8,000, right? For 2,000 shares, 2,000 extra shares, its excess amount is credited to share allotment account or adjusted with share allotment account. Okay, see, in previous question what happened? This 2,000 extra shares were rejected. So this extra 8,000 rupees was refunded. That is why we have credited the bank account here. We have credited bank account in that case, right? But in this case, we are not refunding any amount. We are adjusting the amount with share allotment. That is why share allotment account is credited here. Okay, I hope you understand the difference, right? So again, you need to write the narration being share application amount for 10,000 shares transferred to share capital account and excess amount for 2,000 shares adjusted with allotment. Okay, writing the narration properly is very, very important. Okay, right. So these two were the entries for application. Now again, there will be change in the allotment entry because share allotment account is being affected here, right? So second process is allotment process. We need to do the entry. First, company will ask to pay the allotment amount. So while asking, there is no change in the entry. Okay, company is asking to pay 3 rupees during allotment. So share allotment account debit. Share allotment account debit to share capital account. Okay, 10,000 shares at the rate rupees 3. Company is asking 3 rupees per share during allotment. Right, so 30,000 rupees company asked to pay. So again, 30,000 is credited. Write the narration being share allotment amount for 10,000 shares at the rate rupees 3 per share due. Okay, this amount is due. Company has asked. Now, while payment, what the shareholders will say? We have already paid you excess amount of rupees 8,000 during application. Right? So you have not rejected the shares. You have not refunded us any amount. So this 8,000 rupees is extra with you. Okay, you told that you will adjust it during allotment. So now while making payment, shareholders will pay 8,000 rupees less than what needs to be paid. See, company asked them to pay 30,000 rupees. But now they will not pay the amount for those excess 2,000 shares. So they will not pay 8,000 extra here. Okay. Only 22,000 rupees will be paid during allotment process. Now how to do the entry? Okay, so entry here will be bank account debit. See, we are receiving amount for 8,000 shares now, actually, right? So 8,000 at the rate of 3. Sorry, it's not 8,000 because the adjustment is made on pro rata basis. Allotment is made on pro rata basis, right? So now company has asked them to pay 30,000 rupees, but out of this they have already paid 8,000 rupees excess. So now only 22,000 rupees will be paid during allotment. Okay, so if you want, you can also debit share application account, because during share application the amount was adjusted with allotment. Here share allotment account is credited. So while doing allotment entry, we will debit share application account, debited that excess 8,000 rupees, okay, to share allotment account, rupees 30,000. So company asked to pay 30,000. Out of that, currently we have received rupees 22,000 into the bank account, and 8,000 rupees was extra, which was received during application process. Okay, this is how we do the entry. Write the narration being share allotment money or share allotment account received. Okay, and excess amount adjusted. Okay, that's it. So these two entries you need to do. Now share first call entry will exactly be same like how we have done for the first problem. Okay, entry will be same here, only the amount will change. So 10,000 multiplied with 3 now. So because company is asking 3 rupees on first and final call, so for 10,000 shares, company will ask the amount 3 rupees, which is 30,000. Okay, so you have to do the entry for asking. Then after that, public are paying the amount, okay, during for first and final call. So again 10,000 multiplied with 3. Okay, so entries will be same. I'm not doing it here, you have to do it. Now let's quickly move on to third question. So let's see what is the case here. Bharat Limited issued shares of rupees 100 each. The payment was to be made as follows. Application 20. Now see here, 1,000 shares are being issued, and per share value is 100 rupees. Out of that, application money is 20 rupees and allotment money is 30 rupees and remaining on first and final call. So remaining is how much? 50 rupees is remaining. This will be received during first and final call. Okay, application will receive for how many? 1500 shares, of which 400 shares were rejected. Okay, and 1,000 shares were allotted proportionately to remaining people. Allotted proportionately in the sense, they were allotted on pro rata basis. Okay, then calls were made and the amount was duly received. Okay, so out of 1,500 shares, company is rejecting 400 shares. So remaining actually 1,100 shares are being adjusted to 1,000 people or 1,000 shareholders. Okay, so again, it's not mentioned that excess amount is adjusted with allotment, but it's understood, right? So this is a case when, this is a question in which we have both the cases. Certain shares have been rejected also, and certain shares have been allotted on pro rata basis also. Okay, so we need to do again entries for all the three process: application, allotment and first call, right? First entry for application process will be the same. First, we received amount into our bank account. So bank account debit. We received amount for actually 1500 shares at the rate of rupees 20 per share. So it will be 30,000 rupees. Okay, we received 30,000 rupees for 1500 shares to share application account. 30,000 shares. You need to write the narration being share application amount for 1500 shares at the rate 20 per share received. Okay, now what will be the second entry during application? This is very important. Actually, the entry is share application account debit to share capital account. Okay, this is the entry. Application amount received is 30,000. Okay, how much we need to transfer into share capital account? See, company only wanted to issue how many? 1,000 shares. So for 1,000 shares, 20 rupees was expected. Okay, so how much 20,000 rupees will be transferred to share capital account? How much company wanted, only that will be transferred to share capital account. Now here, again, which account should be credited? So see, 400 shares are being rejected. So rejected in the sense, company needs to refund certain amount immediately. So for 400 shares, company is refunding how much? 20 rupees per share. So 8,000 rupees are being refunded to public. When we are refunding, bank account will be credited. Okay, so bank account credited, 400 shares are rejected for rupees 20 each. So 8,000 rupees are refunded. Okay, then again 100 shares are remaining extra that are being proportionately divided or allotted. It means allotted on pro rata basis. So again, share allotment account will be credited. Okay, for 100 shares, 20 rupees is being adjusted with the share allotment. So 2,000 rupees is adjusted with share allotment account. Clear? So if you want to total, you can check. The total of debit and credit will be same, right? So in first question, only shares were rejected, so we credited bank account. In second question, only shares, all the shares were allotted, so we have only credited share allotment account. In this case, both, in this question, both the cases are happening. Rejection is also there and adjustment is also there. So we have credited both the accounts, right? You need to write narration being share application amount for 1,000 shares is transferred to share capital account, and 400 shares are rejected, and 100 shares, or you can write, and excess amount adjusted with allotment. Okay, these are the two entries for application process. So second process is allotment. First, company will ask to pay the allotment account amount. So what will be the entry? Share allotment account debit to share capital account. Okay, now company is asking for 1,000 shares to pay 30 rupees, right? So company is asking to pay 30,000 during allotment. Same 30,000 rupees will be credited. You can write the narration being share allotment account for 1,000 shares at the rate rupees 30 per share due. This amount is still due. Company has to receive it. So next entry will be when people will, no, shareholders will pay the amount. So while payment, bank account will be debited, bank account debit. Okay, so again, certain amount is adjusted during allotment, right? Excess amount. So in the application process, share allotment account was credited. In the allotment process, share application account will be debited. Share application account debited to share allotment account. Okay, so now see here. So company asked to pay 30,000 rupees, but 2,000 rupees has already been paid in advance, in excess. So 2,000. Now shareholders will only pay 28,000 rupees. So during application, people paid 2,000 rupees extra or excess. Total allotment money is 30,000 rupees. Okay, so you can write the narration being share allotment amount for shares have been received, or yes, has been collected. Clear? This is what you need to write the narration. Then at last we have first and final call process. Entries for here will be same. So for 1,000 shares, company will ask to pay 50 rupees. 50,000 will be the first and final call amount. And then all the shareholders are paying the first and final call amount. So bank account debited to share first and final call account. okay, entry will be same, only this amount, the number of shares are 1000 and first and final call money is 50 rupees. This will be changed. Okay, so you have to do the next entries, right? So the purpose of this video was to clearly explain you about oversubscription, all the cases on oversubscription. Okay, I hope it's clear. So if you liked this particular video, then please hit the like button. Also subscribe to the channel. Okay, you can ask me any doubts in the comment section below. I hope to see you all in my upcoming videos. Till that, happy learning.